Can you please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and a salute to the Texas flag?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Under the Texas flag, I pledge allegiance to the Texas, one state, under God, one indivisible. Please remain standing for a moment of silence. You may pray, meditate, reflect, or remain respectfully silent. At this time, you may begin.
Please remember our mission statement, unity and effort,
pride and result. And this year's motto, Skyline Pride, I own it. Have a great day, Raiders.
I'm Jessica Raven, and your Skyline Scoop starts right now. Raiders, and welcome to your Skyline Scoop for Friday, September 15, 2017. September is Hispanic Heritage Month, and as part of our Hispanic Heritage Month celebration, we will show our Skyline spirit by wearing traditional Hispanic attire today. And let's all work on our Spanish by speaking some phrases to one another. Hola, ¿cómo estás? Muy bien, ¿y tú? Let's take a look at this week's sports coverage with the Skynet sports team.
Good morning, Raiders. I'm Tony here bringing you your sports coverage for the week. Last week on Saturday, the Raider football team played the Mesquite Horns at the Cotton Bowl. Getting right into it, our first highlight shows Velton Gardner passing the ball to Jerrion Prince, who puts the Raiders smack dab in front of the end zone. This, of course, proves to be beneficial for the Raiders, as shown when Velton Gardner is able to easily score a touchdown for the Raiders. Next up, we have Velton Gardner handing the ball to Javius Williams, who manages to penetrate the Horns defense and scores another touchdown. And here we have Velton Gardner able to find the hole in the Horns' defense and gets a nice run, moving the Raiders up to the 20-yard line. As the Horns move up, Skyline barricades their end zone and is able to keep the Horns at bay, forcing the Horns to kick for the field goal. As the game nears its end, Velton Gardner looks for a throw and finds his target, Jarvis Williams, who manages to catch the ball right at the end zone, scoring the final touchdown for the Raiders. The Raiders lost 27-59 against the Horns. Remember to come out to the game and show your support today, where our Raider football team will be versing Duncanville at their school at 7:30. This Tuesday, the Lady Raider volleyball team played against Lake Highlands in the teacher appreciation game. Here's Joanna Castanon speaking with two of the volleyball captains, Estrella and Casey.
Hey there, Raiders. It's me again, Joanna, and today I'm with
Casey Doom, varsity libero number 8.
Estrella Villanueva, captain of the varsity team, and I play a setter.
What do you anticipate to be the biggest challenge on tonight's game?
Staying ahead of the team. Like, don't get down, don't let them get really any points unless they earn it.
I feel like maybe the float serves, that how they serve, and maybe a little bit of how they hit too.
Any particular strategy stressed in practice?
Everything. Everything is stressed in practice. Like, y'all don't understand. It's a little hard. But everything is stressed because we try to get perfect passes, digs, hits, sets, and just try to compete with the other team.
Well, we tend to talk more, and we like to say what we're going to do, to look at every position that we can hit and everything so we can get better at it.
Unfortunately, the Lady Raiders lost the game 0-3. While the Lady Raiders were playing their game, our tennis team was also playing one of their games. The Raider tennis team won against the Berkner tennis team at Samuel Grant Park. Highlighting some of the tennis players, here we have two of the players, Lucas and Alejandro, playing a very defensive game. Bouncing the ball back and forth, Alejandro is able to calculate a shot and give Berkner a ball they can't get. Next up, we have Lucas serving the ball, and after a quick exchange, Lucas is able to hit the ball high enough so Berkner is unable to get it, earning another point for the Raiders. Unfortunately, the Raider tennis team was unable to pull through and lost against Berkner. Even though we haven't been winning everything, our Raiders are learning from their losses, and we can surely look at a more hopeful future. This has been your Sports of the Week. Come out and support your teams, and see you next week, Raiders.
Seniors, you will have your grade level assembly this morning at 10:15 in the auditorium. Senior contracts and permission slips will be picked up and dropped off in House 1. Now, we check in with a brand new segment on the Scoop called Tea Time, where Jordan and Alondra sit down with important people here at Skyline and chat and have some tea.
Hi, I'm Jordan Allen.
Hi, I'm Alejandra Castañeda.
And this is?
I'm Amanda Carner. I'm the Interior Design Cluster Teacher, and I've been at Skyline for 6 years.
What exactly is interior design?
Interior design focuses on people's behaviors with regards to their environments. So we create functional spaces that are aesthetically pleasing. So we'll plan out the space, what everything is, how everything is laid out, and then we'll look at what it looks like. So the floors, the walls, the ceilings, the furniture, and the fabrics, and everything that goes inside.
Okay. So far, what is a highlight of your life?
Well, I recently got married. So I got married in July, and it's been kind of fun to come back to school and have a different last name. And so everybody gets confused because I've changed my name. But that was probably my best day so far in 2017.
What's your worst quality?
My worst quality would be taking on too much. I love a challenge, but sometimes that makes me a little bit busy. But it's kind of exciting to see what's next and to take on something else and to continue to learn.
Okay. One last thing you'd like to say to Skyline before you go.
Skyline Raiders, own it. Find your interests, attend your classes, ask questions, just jump in and make the most out of this year.
Do you need to recover credits from your past years in high school, or are you interested in taking coursework for acceleration? If you're interested in either of these options, then come be a part of the Evening Academy. Evening Academy started on Monday, September 11th, and will meet on Monday, Tuesday, and Thursday every week. Classes will be available at Skyline, Molina, Conrad, and Carter. To register, speak with your counselor today. A lot has changed with the dress code this year. Here's a look at some of your thoughts in this week's fashion segment.
Hey, we're here with Jen.
What's up, Milton?
What's up? I was wondering how you like the new Skyline dress code.
Well, I actually enjoy the new Skyline dress code, but there's just a few flaws that it has. You know, like the ripped jeans policy. Like, I don't like that. I would prefer for them to just let us wear the ripped jeans instead of regular jeans like the ones that you're wearing, you know?
So where did you get your outfit from?
Well, this one, I got it from a softball tournament, as you can see.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to College Station.
Mm-hmm.
And then the jeans I got on, did I get them at? I think it was JCPenney.
Mm-hmm.
My shoes, Foot Locker. Uh-huh. No, they got the hook up there.
It's cool.
Yeah. What about you? Where did you get your outfit from?
I got the Pumas from Foot Locker.
Yeah, man.
I got the jeans from H&M.
For real?
Yeah. And I got the shirt from JCPenney.
Oh, wow. So, another thing, you guys that support the Skyline Lady Raiders volleyball team for the fundraiser,
mm-hmm.
Want to buy something?
Yeah, I like that shirt right there.
For real?
Yeah.
All right. But anyways.
Hi, what's your name and grade?
I'm Deliana Martinez, and I'm a junior.
How do you like the new Skyline dress code?
I like it because I get to wear, like, cute outfits every day, and I don't have to wear the uncomfortable uniform, and it's ugly, so.
Where did you get your outfit from?
I think I got this from Champs, and then I got my jeans from Macy's, and then I got my chanclas from Water Park in San Antonio.
Okay. Who are you?
My name is Ms. Harris.
And what do you teach?
I teach economics.
Well, how do you like the new Skyline dress code?
I like having the standardized dress code because I don't have to look for color of your pants and color of your shirt and are you correct. I'll have to look for shoes and length of skirt.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
All right. Hi, what is your name?
Hello, my name is John Christopher.
All right, what is your position at Skyline?
I'm a hall monitor.
What are your thoughts about Skyline's new dress code?
Well, actually, I like it, but, I mean, there's no problem. As long as kids go to school, do what they need to do. You know, other than that, that's basically what it is. As long as they do what they're supposed to do and come in and be respectful to everybody, and, you know, it won't be no problem.
I would thank you for your answers.
The University of Texas in Arlington is sponsoring free SAT math prep sessions. Go to www.uta.edu/universitycrossroads to register. There will be 4 sessions, September 16th, 23rd, 30th, and October 7th, at 2 locations, Duncanville High School and W.T. White High School. Bring your own calculators. Check out the flyers on the library doors in the cafeteria or the counseling office. Speaking of the library, you may have noticed some changes in the library staff this year. Here's a look at the new librarians.
Hey guys, my name is Mrs. Horner and I am one of three librarians this year, and I want to welcome you and invite you to come to the library this year. The only thing you need is a pass from your teacher, and you do need it before school, but we are open from 8 to 4:45, and if you want a pass, you can come whenever you like. Just ask us and we'll provide it for you for the semester. We can't wait to see you.
Hi guys, I'm Miss O'Neill. I'm one of the librarians at Skyline. We have a lot of great things to offer you, and we have a lot of programs and different events going on at the library, so we hope you'll come see us and let us help you out with your schoolwork and for your pleasure reading. And it's going to be a great school year. Thanks so much.
Hello, I'm Ms. Hernandez. I'm one of the new librarians here at Skyline. It's my first year as a librarian. I'm really excited to be here at Skyline. As Ms. Horner and Ms. O'Neill said, we have a lot to offer you this year, so come on in and check us out and come say hi.
Come watch with excitement as the Skyline Raider Band competes in the Battle of the Bands on October 7th. Get your tickets in the band hall from 2 to 4 every day for $10. The competition will be at Beverly D. Humphrey Tiger Stadium in Lancaster, Texas. Voting for your Student Center starts soon. Here's your Student Center sponsor, Ms. Christensen, with a look at how it's all going to go down.
Thomas Jefferson once wrote in the Declaration of Independence that every man is entitled to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Everyone is entitled to those things, but you cannot secure those rights without voting. Voting is the way to keep your rights intact. It's also extremely important because if you don't, somebody else tells you how to run your life. But you can't even begin with that without registering to vote. Registering to vote is key if you're going to vote at all. It is not only a right for you as an American citizen, it is a duty, something you should be proud to do because you are an American.
Do you already register to vote? Don't forget, you have the power. Your decision counts, so don't forget, register and vote. ¿Ya se registraron para votar? Recuerden, ustedes tienen el control y el poder para elegir a nuestros próximos representantes. No se olviden, regístrense y voten.
Make sure to register and vote.
Hi guys, I just wanted to encourage everybody out there that can register to vote and remember to vote.
Register to vote, vote. Regístrate para votar, vota.
Register to vote and vote.
I just want to encourage all of our students who are eligible to register to vote, and when you have registered to vote in every election. Get your voice heard. Register to vote.
I want to encourage you to register to vote and vote.
What's good, Skyline? It's Mr. Schwag, inviting you to join me on Tuesday, September 26th, for National Voter Registration Day. Registering only takes a minute, but it can make a lifetime of difference. So if you're 18 years old and a U.S. citizen, then join me on this Tuesday, September 26th, in the Senior Cafe during all lunches. Register and vote. Thank you.
Register to vote.
And vote.
Take advantage of the Dallas ISD College Fair next Wednesday from 5:30 to 8:30 at Ellis Davis Fieldhouse. All grade levels are invited. Please register at www.gotocollegefairs.com. If you have any questions, go to the counseling suite for more information. Now, the moment you've all been waiting for, Angel Galvin and your Weekend Review.
Hi, my name is Angel Galvin, and this is your Weekend Review. This past Monday was 9/11, a day that is remembered as the day four commercial airline planes were hijacked and crashed into the Twin Towers and other monuments. The assault was carried out by the Al-Qaeda terrorist group, a radical Islamic organization based in Afghanistan and Pakistan. The damage was devastating at the time, and many lives were lost. Many memorial services were held across the nation for those who lost their lives and those who were affected by 9/11. Our thoughts and prayers to all those affected by 9/11. Moving on across the Pacific, China announced plans to end sales of all fossil-fueled power cars. Jin Guobin, Vice Minister of the Industry and Information Technology Ministry, is finishing a timetable for ending production and sales of gas-powered cars while stepping up incentives for hybrid and electric cars. But no exact deadline has been announced. China is the largest car exporter in the world. There are 160 million cars on the road in China, and the 28 million new cars it sold in 2016 were responsible for almost a third of all car sales worldwide. The transition from fossil-fueled powered cars to electric cars is expected to reduce the pollution in China by a significant amount. Coming back home, Judge Sidney Fitzwater has ruled the city of Dallas can remove the Robert E. Lee statue from Lee Park. Last Wednesday, a Dallas judge granted a temporary restraining order on the removal of the statue due to mass protests. The restraining order was soon overruled by Judge Fitzwater. The crane initially meant to remove the statue was too small to get the job done, so a larger crane was brought in from Houston. The second crane was then involved in a deadly collision, resulting in the death of a semi-truck driver. The removal of the statue has yet again been delayed, and authorities are pondering on how to deal with the situation going forward. We now go to Alondra Marquez for your scoop on Hurricane Irma.
Thanks, Angel. Hurricane Irma has impacted many in the South Atlantic with traumatic disasters and unreeling debris. To give a quick recap on, here's a clip of the catastrophe from Cuba to Florida.
Hurricane Irma leaves 6.2 million Florida homes in the dark and over 60% of the entire state. Electricity companies in Florida claim that the state should be without power for weeks. Hurricane Irma has heavily pounded populated areas of up central Florida as it carved through the state with high winds, storm surges, and heavy rains. Over 100,000 people statewide have took refuge in shelters. Estimates suggest that the two recent hurricanes, Irma and Harvey, could together cost the U.S. economy about $290 billion. Now, with tropical storms that have sustained winds of up to 70 miles per hour, Irma was located about 70 clicks east of the Florida state capital, Tallahassee, and now heading towards the Georgia borders. On Monday, Irma is expected to weaken as it moves further into the U.S. towards southern Georgia. It is set to hit eastern Alabama on Tuesday, a few hours past noon. Early morning Wednesday, it should be closing in towards Tennessee and landing.
This has been your weather forecast. Back to you, Angel.
You know what time it is now? Probably like 9:30-ish. But it's also time for your weekend review. Saturday is International Coastal Cleanup Day. Good luck with that. Sunday is Neighborhood Day. Take it off, Mr. Rogers.
It's a beautiful day in this neighborhood, a beautiful day for a neighbor. Would you be mine? Could you be mine? It's a neighborly day in this beauty wood, a neighborly day for beauty. Would you be mine? Could you be mine? I have always wanted to have a neighbor just like you. I've always wanted to live in a neighborhood with you, so let's make the most of this beautiful day, beautiful day. Since we're together, we might as well say, would you be mine? Could you be mine? Won't you be my neighbor? Won't you please? Won't you please? Please won't you be my neighbor?
Now, enjoy your clip of the week.
Frosty Crane, yeah, pizza is the pizza, yeah, for you and me.
This has been your week in review, and remember, I don't own it, you don't own it, we own it.
That's all we have for this week, Raiders. Be sure to follow us at Skynet Broadcasting and take Skynet with you wherever you go by texting at SKYN to 81010 to receive mobile broadcast of your Skyline scoop. I'm Jessica Raven saying there are three sides to every story, yours, mine, and the truth. Catch you next week, Raiders.